This is how to get percent purity by titration. A 0.9876 gram sample of impure calcium hydroxide is dissolved in 100 mL of water. 25 mL of the resulting solution is then titrated with 0.2017 molar HCl. What is the percent purity of the calcium hydroxide if the titration requires 28.09 mL of acid? Okay. It would be very helpful if we knew how many moles of calcium hydroxide we had, because then we could figure out how many grams we had and the percent purity. The way to figure this out is to realize that we're titrating with HCl. So we have a concentration of HCl. We have a mils of HCl. And maybe you remember that if you have volume times concentration, you can get yourself moles, or in this case, millimoles. Our volume is 28.09 mils. Our concentration is 0.2017 millimoles of HCl per milliliter of solution. When we multiply this out, it turns out that we have 5.6657 millimoles of HCl. Okay, now, here the stoichiometry is a little bit important. Calcium hydroxide has this formula right here, and if we think about HCl reacting with it, there's usually 1H plus to 1 hydroxide. So the stoichiometry here is 2 HCls, and this isn't a typical way we might write the reaction, but we're going to wind up with calcium chloride dissolved in solution when we're done, and 2 moles of water. So there are 2 HCls for every 1 calcium hydroxide. So we will take our 5.6657 millimoles of HCl, and we will recognize that for every 2 millimoles of HCl, we have 1 millimole of calcium hydroxide. So, dividing that number by 2 gives us 2.8329 millimoles of calcium hydroxide. In our 25 mil solution that we titrated. Because remember, we didn't titrate the whole thing, we titrated 25 mils. So there is going to have to be an adjustment to figure out how much was in the total sample. We had 2.8329 millimoles, and that's in 25 mils of solution of calcium hydroxide. We just have to remember that the entire sample size was 100. So we're essentially going to have to multiply this by 4. When we do that, we discover that we had 11.3315 millimoles of calcium hydroxide in the entire sample. All right. Well, we've got millimoles of calcium hydroxide. It's not too hard from this point on. We will just take our 11.3315 millimoles of calcium hydroxide. We will divide by 1,000 millimoles per 1 mole, just to get our unit square. And if you add up the atomic masses, you'll discover that there are 74.0938 grams of calcium hydroxide for every 1 mole of calcium hydroxide. That's the molar mass. And multiplying this out will give us 0.83959 grams of calcium hydroxide. Okay, now, percent purity is, of course, actual, I guess you could call it, compound over grams of sample times 100. So our actual amount of compound that we have is 0.83959 grams of calcium hydroxide. The sample size is given to us up here, 0.9876 grams of sample. And multiply by 100, and we come up with 85.04% purity. And looks like 4 sig figs are going in most of the places, so I think 4 sig figs coming out sounds pretty good. That's all there is to that.